Right now, with the borders closed, it means the students are able to leave, but they won't be able to get back in, not with any certainty anyway. So we've contacted the families, we've talked to them about this, and we've shown them the opportunities we can provide, like a Kiwi summer holiday. Our homestay families are all happy to have the students and have them part of the family during the holiday period. Hi, konnichiwa. My name's Carl Everett. I'm the International Director here at Christchurch Boys High School. We're the largest and oldest state boys school in Christchurch City, New Zealand. So, like the rest of you recently, we've been dealing with the lockdowns due to COVID-19. It's a difficult time for the world right now, but thankfully in New Zealand we are open and schools are open, and we're enjoying no cases down here in the South Island. When the lockdown occurred in Christchurch, the schools were pre-warned and pre-prepared. They had good online systems available, and the teachers were delivering their curriculum online to students at home. And they even offered devices to those students who didn't have the appropriate devices. So we were really happy with how things went during the lockdown, and think we're pretty prepared and well organised in case that should happen again. We hope it won't, but in case it does, we feel that we're very well prepared here at Christchurch Boys. So all of the students in the school were already connected online through OneNote software, and so it really wasn't difficult for the teachers to then extend the capability of that software to be able to deliver video lessons and live lessons to the students as well. All of the students at school use devices in their normal day-to-day classroom and subjects, so it really wasn't difficult for them to then extend that to broader lessons when they were at home. Everyone is connected through Wi-Fi, and it was very easy for the teachers to deliver lessons from home to students in their homes as well. So it wasn't really a big step to make. As the International Director, I was able to drop into the lessons of the students. So while they were online talking with their teachers, I was able to visit those online classrooms and check on all of my students. We also have a homestay coordinator and another office manager, and we were on a roster ringing up the boys and just making sure that they were happy and that they were staying healthy and you know, making sure they were getting out of their rooms and doing exercise and all of those things. So long-term students that are with us now, thankfully, we have a lot of support through the Christmas period. So that period when the students would normally be going home and visiting families, we've put in place programs for them to sign up to that will include a variety of holiday programs and camps, and also academic study if they wish and want to do more during that period. Most of our students are long-term. They're here to graduate and then go on to university here or somewhere else in the world. And so they're really dedicated to finishing their time with us and staying through this period when they can't travel. Right now, with the borders closed, it means the students are able to leave, but they won't be able to get back in, not with any certainty anyway. So we've contacted the families, we've talked to them about this, and we've shown them the opportunities we can provide, like a Kiwi summer holiday. Our homestay families are all happy to have the students and have them part of the family during the holiday period.
I think it's a shocking news for some students, but I think it's actually a rare chance of enjoying it.
Yeah, and to be honest, as much as I, you know, I feel for the students not being able to see their family, but it is quite easy to connect as we are through video now and through Skype and Zoom and that kind of software, so they're not alone. But at the same time, it's giving them a chance to spend their whole summer in New Zealand, really finding out what Kiwis love the most, which is the outdoors and that opportunity to go away on holiday together in the summer months. And at the same time, it's helping them to really stay on top of their English language development. So I think the students for 2021 will be more prepared than the students we've had in the past.
That's true. Some students are struggling with their English when they come back because they've been speaking Japanese all the time.
Yeah, often the students will go home for the summer and sometimes the gains they've made with their English during the year takes a few steps back after being at home and speaking their own language again for that long period of time. So yeah, I think this is a unique opportunity for the students that are staying through the summer.
Our borders closed at the moment. What does it mean for a student in Japan who wants to come and study in New Zealand?
Yeah, so this is a difficult group. We've had students that have wished to attend this year and who have been unable, and really there's not much we can do, but the New Zealand government is working on solutions for this. So, you know, they're being very careful and very safe about the borders and keeping them closed until good process and a really good way of processing the new students and visitors can be found. The message is, I mean, New Zealand is a great place and, you know, the reason we're a safe place at the moment is because we have a government that was quick to act and, you know, cares about its people. So I think it's still, you know, a great choice of places to come to, and I think once there's a good plan for the border, you know, you'll be welcomed with open arms. And we hope that those plans will start rolling out soon, and also vaccines are also being developed very quickly, so it won't be long. So keep the dream alive about coming to New Zealand, and we'll certainly welcome you as soon as we can.